CNN Health, as well as pretty much every other news outlet, just reported that according to the latest study, fish oil may raise the risk of stroke and heart issues. I've actually downloaded this latest study and the supplementary materials. And there is something quite interesting there. Couple critical lines which were not very well communicated in the headlines. And if you are in any way interested in omegas or fish oil, let me explain what it means for your health and longevity. Because for a change, the study is not that badly designed compared to other observational studies. But what's more important, it has confirmed what was found in the previous research. Reduced strength and vital, which were all randomized and placebo-controlled. So, this latest study has confirmed that omega-3 oil can increase the chances of AFib, atrial fibrillation. That's an electrical problem in the heart muscle membranes, which leads to irregular beats. Instead of steady open-close rhythm, it gets stuck and then quickly catches up. My mom has this condition and it's quite unpleasant. What's worse is that because the blood doesn't flow as consistently, it can create microclots and damage the brain. That's the reason why people with AFib are often on blood thinners, so that clotting doesn't happen. On the other hand, omega-3 oils, when taken correctly, have the list of benefits which goes on and on and on. It actually improves other heart parameters, improves brain health, improves muscles, eyesight, reduces inflammation, slows down aging in general. That's the reason why every longevity doctor I know of, from Peter Attia to my own functional doctor, recommends taking some omegas. But what about the risks, you ask? Yes, let's take a closer look at the supplemental table, where not only AFib is reported, but other outcomes such as heart attacks and all-cause mortality. And what do we see there? Yes, AFib hazard ratio is significantly up. That small number indicates statistical significance, which actually matches the findings from the previous randomized study, where huge 4-gram doses had the same effect, AFib. But let's look at the next lines. Heart attacks and deaths are all down, which also matches the previous data from the placebo-controlled studies. And so I have two big questions for you. Number one, would you rather be dead or have AFib? Because that seems to be the trade-off in megadosing. And second, what if you take a smaller dose which does not lead to any increase in AFib confirmed by the vital study, and on top use several techniques to quadruple omega-3 benefits? Wouldn't that be great? You'll both save money and unlock multiple health and especially brain health benefits. If yes, here's a video you have to watch right now while you are on the subject. Living is smart, aging is bad, and I'll see you there.